Our course is part of the family of courses in the UC University of California online instruction pilot project. Once you take the course, you are just like a student sitting in the front row, and when you get done, you have transferable credit. For that, you will pay the same cost as tuition. We're marketing to the world, so you might be in your living room in Burma taking this class and walking away at the end of a full semester with a very rigorous course. This isn't just 6 weeks of a sub course as often you see in MOOCs. This is the full 15-week course in the case of many semesters, or a 10-week course if it's a quarter system in the UC program. And you're going to walk away with the actual course and a document that says that you got the actual course. You took the exact course as the students did who are sitting in the front row of that.
You used the word marketing. Is this essentially a way for the university to make some money? What's the reason for it?
So the reason for it is looking at some of California finances and realizing we have to find other ways to fulfill some of the budget requirements of our departments. So it helps everybody. It's a win-win in both sense, in which the department gets a little bit of extra money for doing this. But on top of that, a student that might not have access to University of California quality schools can now get that.
So let's see how the system works on the laptop here.
Sure. So one of the things we're going to show is this is a screen capture. This is a lecture on YouTube that we have augmented with clicker questions. So in my face-to-face class, we ask questions and I offer a multiple choice option. The students take their clickers out like a TV remote control and they vote. And what we've done is we've made this from being a passive experience where you're just watching a YouTube video to an active experience where I've augmented this video with small questions interspersed throughout the lecture that stop, ask you a multiple choice question, you then click with your mouse on one of the radio buttons, and then it tells you not only whether you got the right or wrong answer, but also the histogram of everyone else in the class. It's really quite nice. And I can show an example of that now if you like.
Let's do that.
So here's the video playing as it normally would, and I'm just going to click to a particular section, and I'm now here saying,
in the model of how income and
so this is what I've done here is I film myself in front of a green screen in high definition, and then I place myself in front of slides, and the slides are rendered to high definition. So what that means is you're getting a really, really good view, very much like the weatherman in terms of the quality of the video. So that's just to talk about YouTube. And when the video gets up to the blue dot, and this is a blue dot where a question is going to come up, the video is going to pause, and now the video is paused, and now there's a question which is asking you, which of the following is not a great example of abstraction from what you've learned so far? And you then choose something.
What does a comic
do?
What a comic does when he tells a joke. How a master surgeon would teach an appointee a particular technique, and so forth.
And so I might choose something. An elevator pitch for a screenplay. Okay, which of these is not abstraction? And say submit. And one of the things you're going to see is it'll come up and show you that you clicked the wrong answer. The right answer here is that how a master surgeon would teach an apprentice a particular technique. Because in that particular case, you don't want to abstract away the big idea. You want the details about the surgery technique is the most important thing.
But what he doesn't get is being next to you and asking you questions and being involved and maybe with the other students.
Right. And so the way we supplement that is we have a lot of online, we use Adobe Connect right now, but we have a lot of video conferencing time for that student to get face-to-face time, virtual face-to-face time with a teaching assistant, and I even have office hours. So if you're going to pay real money to take a course, not just free, then I'm going to give you some of my time for that effort. So the instructor of the online course would offer their time through video conferencing. So I'll have some time that you can sign up and talk to me for that.
What do you think about the MOOC?
I think the MOOCs are great. I think the MOOCs can transform education by giving stuff away. I just love the idea of giving things away to the world. I think they're wonderful. What you miss is you don't get that face-to-face. And they make up by having forums where I might ask a question and other students will answer those questions.
Online forums.
Online forums for that. And that's very reasonable. You just don't get the face-to-face time of an instructor, and you certainly can't scale an instructor times 100,000.